This Let's Play was supported by these awesome hobby companies.
Hello everybody and welcome to Let's Play World War Zero using the Guns and Drums system. I am joined by Cad from Foreground. Hello. And today we have a bit of a different battle for you. So the ones you've seen before were sort of historical scenarios, so they're a little bit asymmetric. This time we're going points based and we're trying to keep it balanced, yeah?
Yeah, so we're both about 1,350 points, which is a kind of, points may change.
Yep. Do you have 1,350 men on the table?
Not quite. So you've got, each one of your battalions is 700 men.
Okay.
So what's that, five sevens, why can I not do this, 350?
Yeah.
3,500 regular infantry, you've got an extra 300 grenadiers.
Okay.
And you've got
I've got some cavalry.
Another
here,
400 cavalry.
Yeah.
So this is this isn't a big battle, but for the scale of Guns and Drums, so if we were doing say some of the historical battles like the Battle of Minden, that's 200,000-300,000 soldiers.
Yeah.
So the system is designed where you're playing at a sort of the divisional level rather than the mass.
Yeah.
But that's only because with scales, you could make it slightly different. We could have them, each one of these is a brigade.
Yep.
And it does talk in the rules about how you could play, like, zoom out, zoom in, your game. I've got about the same amount. I've got six battalions of regulars, the same as you. Mine are a bit smaller, so they tend to be five stands and four stands. No particular reason, we've just gone with Justin's units having more resilience, so they're more likely to stand than mine, but mine give me more potential activations in different locations. Anybody that's seen the guide on how to play already, the officers are actually the activations. So just because I have more units doesn't actually give me activation advantage like you might get in some other games.
Yeah, it's why you'll notice I have one of my commanders here, my CIC, Commander-in-Chief. He is actually split between these units because if I didn't have him in range of the cannons, when the cards come up, I can't activate the cannons unless there's an officer there to shout at them.
Yes.
You know, make it load, ready, fire!
And the same as...
I'm not sure what that would be in French.
Oh, I can't remember. I did it at school.
Funny, so did I, but the teacher was cute.
what we're doing is instead of just showing a stand-up battle where we're going to go at each other, we've done one of the scenarios, which is defending a town over a river. So I've started with only one of my brigades on the table. I was allowed to pick the brigade.
Yep.
So I've picked a brigade with some grenadiers in the back. They're my reserve, effectively, is the way my brain's thinking of them. I've got two units of regulars here defending this ford, another unit of regulars here defending this ford, and my plan was, because I had to deploy before I knew what Justin was doing, my plan was that Justin's closest entry point is where his artillery came in, because he's got the whole of that board edge, and he did have the whole of this board edge over here.
Yeah, but I thought, you know,
I don't want to turn
my back to camera.
Yeah. Not just that, it would take you too long, potentially.
It would take quite a bit of time, but for me, the way I've deployed, it's actually, I'm trying to consider the movement. So you'll notice I've got three of my units are on an angle.
Yeah.
So you can kind of tell they're going to swing up and across, and then when they're in position, they're going to turn to face.
Yes.
Because I can only, from column, turn left or right to go into line.
Yeah, and once again, when people get the rules, they'll see that Prussians are the exception to that. They can actually form forwards.
Yeah. It's also why the other three here, they're going to be marching straight up the table here, turning and marching across the other ford. My cavalry are hopefully going to go up for a flanking maneuver, although with the river here, you're in a really well sort of anchored position.
Yes, there's two main bottlenecks. Now, Justin can cross the main river at half speed. If he crosses with cavalry, they lose their courage saves from shooting. So cavalry want to be going across the ford. Cavalry charging the front of formed line infantry that are loaded can go badly.
Yep.
If they've activated that turn, effectively they count as unloaded, so they can't defensive fire.
Yeah, that's a rule you're wanting to test in this year, yeah?
Yeah.
And we have a couple like that, but we'll point them out as we go.
Yeah, and there have been some changes since the versions that you've seen, but that's because it's still in development.
Yep.
So if you see things that are slightly different, that'll be because we're trying different things.
Yeah, the main engine's the same though. So if you're wanting to learn how to play, we do have a round breakdown out there already.
Yeah.
Shall we?
Yeah, so the first thing we're going to do is draw our activation cards.
Yeah, who's it going to be? Brigadier 3, so that's cavalry.
Because it's not historical, we just named them Brigadier 1, 2, and 3.
Yeah.
And the CIC,
yep.
Although I obviously have Commander-in-Chief Spotted Dick.
Yeah. Right, so my CIC has to be, what is it? Over the rank.
What, Major General?
Yeah, Major General Le Grand Fromage. right, so that's my Brigadier 3. So that is these guys here. So that's my cavalry. Now, we are on turn 2, which is why I already have inspiration tokens on the board. My first activation was to bring everybody in. We figured everybody wouldn't want to be watching me just moving guys in and measuring 8 inches off the table edge.
Yeah.
So we've done that, and now we're into the round 2. So he has a couple of options. So cavalry in line. Can move 12 inches. So that will bring him to there. Or I can start spending some inspiration to get them moving a bit quicker, yeah?
Yes. So you were very lucky in the first turn that the first card that came up was your CIC, who could move everything.
Yeah.
So if you're now moving your cavalry, you've got the 2 inspiration tokens, so there's no point in taking any more because you're only a level 2.
Yeah. So I can burn at least 1 for movement. Yeah. And so cavalry for extra movement, 2d3?
2d3.
And I will spend an inspiration token to make it an automatic pass because I would have to take a check otherwise, yes?
Yes.
Right, let's see how far I go. Ooh, so that'll be an additional 4 inches.
On 12, 16. Yeah.
16, that's pretty nice. I'll do it on the...
Luckily I could do maths then, that would have been embarrassing.
I assume the light cavalry are the guys without the banner, yeah?
Yeah. No, they've both got banners. So the light cavalry are the ones without...
Oh, sorry, I've mixed up my guys.
Okay. So the light cavalry have a funny hat rather than a tricorn. They've got like more of a little floppy thing on top. Like a forage cap. It's the light blue, so you've actually got them mixed, I think. Because that's heavy.
This is what happens when you play at this scale.
That's heavy, that's light.
That's light. Yeah, so I want my light cavalry to be on the front.
It's also because last night, Justin played with Commodore Rob, and Commodore Rob smashed the cavalry.
Oh, man. Rob, buddy, you hurt me.
Yeah.
So they're going to move the light cavalry, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, so they're going 16. Straight up the table, big long run. Do I want to do it with the others? Yeah, let's do it with the others, see what I get. So, 2d3 again.
Another 4.
Same again. So, they are keeping pace. Now, I need to be careful of doing that, because I could have these guys go so fast, so far, their commander might come out of range.
So, the light cavalry are okay, because they've got the scout special rule.
Yeah.
So, you can actually command them within 24 inches.
Mm. So... 16, about there, same again. There we go. And my commander, he's just gonna, wait for me. And that's that.
Next card.
I just need to make sure and mark that I have activated those.
My CIC here. Now he's got 3 inspiration tokens because we played out the first turn.
Mm-hmm.
I actually started deployed, so unlike Justin, I could build up more tokens.
Yeah, yeah.
And the only thing I'm going to do
mm-hmm.
is I'm going to activate. This was my I was really hoping he'd come up because I'm going to activate my gun here.
Yeah, your cannon.
Yeah, my cannon. It's going to fire down one of your columns.
Yeah, this one you've got all 7 of them.
Yeah. So with the way your artillery work is that you can. It's a bit abstract considering that's 700 men, but that's not one gun. That's a battery of guns.
Yep.
So they get 1 dice per stand in the unit that you can shoot a line through.
Yeah.
So they get 1 equipment dice.
Mm-hmm.
So they've got 7 of those, 1 skill dice.
Yep.
British artillery, a skill 5 plus.
Mm-hmm.
It's only a 3-pounder, so it's got 7 6 up dice.
Uh-huh.
I'm then going to be a bit funny.
Okay.
Spend 2 inspiration tokens.
Ah.
I'm going to use those to increase the skill dice, because you can't increase equipment with inspiration.
Uh-huh.
It's 5 plus, 4 plus, 3 plus.
On the black dice?
Only the black dice.
Okay.
But he's going to get 2 more activations this turn, I might as well do it now.
Yep.
Knocked over a tree. Oh, so the one that I didn't increase, did increase, didn't do anything.
But the others definitely did. I think you've got, what, 4 there?
No, 2, because it's only 6 up on the equipment, because it's such a light gun.
Right. So from where we are here, I'm going to spend the inspiration off Brigadier 1 to increase it, and I'm going to throw him into it
yeah.
to make it, You're shooting into my regular guys, yeah? So that is regular infantry battalion, courage of 5 to begin.
Yep.
So what's the modifier?
-1 for artillery, +1 for your officer, +1 for your inspiration.
So force?
So +1 total, yeah.
Force? Okay. And 2 dice to make.
Yep.
Yes!
Second time he's done that this game.
Yeah, because round one we were shooting at each other.
Yeah. That is all I'm going to activate. I don't want to activate any of his other units because nobody's in range.
Okay, do your thing.
That's it. Oh, card.
Yeah.
I thought you meant do my thing, not...
So, Brigadier 2 for me. So that's this line of infantry over here.
Yeah.
So he's going to have 2 of them with the inspiration to get additional D3 move because of infantry. And the other one will have to test. So I'll do the one that has to test first. And they're testing on a 5.
Yep.
So here's hoping. Yes! So everybody's getting D3 movement. So for the first unit, is an additional 3.
Yep.
So 11 inches?
Yep. So column infantry move 8, line infantry move 4.
Okay.
Like when they formed line.
Yep. And whenever they're formed line, they can still do that additional D3?
Yes.
Okay. So these guys are going 11, which is absolutely fabulous. So I'll just move the front guy of the unit, and then everybody else will shimmy up behind. Now, how precise are you guys aiming to be with the movement in this particular game, CAD?
Relatively precise. It's
bring it back a little and just turn slightly.
We're not going to be as hard in the rules. That's something, obviously, you and your opponent can discuss. But part of that is because when you're wheeling, things can go a bit squiffy.
Yeah.
In the rules, it's going to tell people how to do things, but it's not like... You must measure this exact angle and do that kind of thing.
So we're not breaking out the protractor?
Not breaking out the protractor at all.
Okay. Next unit is going for D3, but I am spending inspiration to get them rolling. So for them, they get an additional 2, so 10 inches.
Yep.
Okay. So get the front guy for 10. To there. Try not to hit my other infantry. And everybody else moving up behind.
Yeah, so movement-wise, as long as you don't have a floating tape measure, you'll be okay.
All right, and the last one, they're also going to use the inspiration. Mm-hmm. And what do they get?
Ooh.
An additional 3. Nice. So let's see. These guys are going 11. So that's going to bring them up to there. This unit didn't move as far because I just wheeled them very, very slightly. So they're going to... There. Commander moves 12 because he's on horseback.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, he's just going to nip himself up.
So all commander models, no matter how the model looks, always moves 12. So it allows you to potentially, if you want to do some guy sat in his lounge chair reading a newspaper, he still moves 12.
That's fine. So that's his 3
They
units.
Need the activation token.
Activation token, thank you.
And that's
it. New card. My
CIC.
Okay, this is interesting. So, for a 12-inch range, grenadiers are just out. That's unfortunate. But what is going to happen, if I take this out of the way, 2 guns are going to move and fire.
Not use their Swiss carriage to fire twice.
See, I kind of want to close with you, because I think whenever I get within 8, I get 3 equipment dice.
Yeah, you get to use a canister.
Yeah, in fact... They're just going to sit and shoot for this round and take the 2 shots.
Yeah.
So I think from where I'm at, I can get 2 bases.
Yep.
So that's 2 white dice, 1 black dice, all on 6s.
All on 6s because you're French.
Okay. Vive la France. Nope. First shot. Second shot from the same gun. Nope. Second gun.
The guns can shoot with each shot. They could declare a different target. There's no point for Justin because he's not going to get a better shot.
Yeah, I am literally just targeting this unit here to get 2 bases. Looking 6s, no.
And the second shot?
Second shot, no, denied.
There's rounds buzzing around everywhere, and they're like,
they're landscaping.
Yeah.
But that'll do, so do I want to activate anything else? Ah, I didn't use his,
I assumed you were using it to make them move faster, sorry.
Good idea.
Otherwise, I would have pointed.
This is why I think he's quite the Napoleonic character, because he's just like, don't interrupt your opponent when he's making a mistake.
Yeah.
I will use it to get them moving faster. So I'll start with this unit.
Yeah.
Order to make it automatic, and then D3 for an additional 2, so 10 inches on them. So for 10 inches, I'm going to try and keep them a little further back, so they'll get to about here, where my little finger is on the wheel. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And that should let them all move up and around. That's pretty handy there. Other unit. Activation, inspiration, and D3. For one extra movement. 9 inches. So these guys are going to stay behind. So they're going to end up by here. Dunt. And then everybody else is going to line up behind. Now, there is a reason that I'm not swinging further forward, because the musket range in this game is 8. And my thinking is, if I can hold my guys back a little further, form line, and then start marching in.
Because pre-measuring is the thing in this game, I was exactly going to be thinking about measuring the distance, mm-hmm. if you'd move further forwards,
yeah.
so I could then check whether it's worthwhile just advancing a little bit
yeah.
to fire. But
well, I think I'm over 12, which would be it.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I'll probably be able to do it, actually, because I get a move before I fire.
Uh-huh. Well, if you think, you're moving 4.
I'll be slowed down as soon as I hit the river.
This part of the river?
Oh, 12. Yeah. Why did I think I had a 12? It's because we've been playing too much Jerry's game. I've forgotten how to play my own game.
Oh, okay. This Let's Play could get interesting. Brigadier 1.
Brigadier 1, which is your infantry. You moved your Brigadier 1 instead of your CIC.
Whoops. So he was about there?
That'd probably be good for me, because you might not be able to command your Grenadiers anymore.
All right, well, the CIC would move to about here.
Yeah.
Just to be within 2 inches of this front unit, and yep. definitely within for the cavalry. Or the cannons. So he will activate this unit.
Anybody might think we'd been drinking. We haven't. I thought I'd better clarify that as soon as I said it.
Yeah.
Do you want to... One of the things with Grenadiers, before you move them, mm-hmm. if you want to do a moving at the double, the combined action,
yeah.
they do it on a 4+, because they're skill 4,
yeah.
and Grenadiers are well-disciplined,
yeah.
so they get to re-roll it if they fail.
Uh-huh.
So if you're debating whether to do it or not, 4+ yeah. with a re-roll.
I will do it for 4+ with a re-roll. So come on. No.
Re-roll.
God, what have you done to me?
Ah, it's fine.
All right, so now I roll for the distance. For an additional 3, so that's 11 inches on the Grenadiers.
Yeah.
That's actually pretty damn good. So the Grenadiers are going to move up and rotate ever so slightly to be about here. Ooh, they're getting very quickly up to where I want them. That's good. Now, they will go at half speed across the river, but if they're in column,
yep.
that's still 4 inches, yeah?
Yes.
Nice.
And they can still move at the double.
Mm-hmm.
So
could get across that river pretty quickly. But
yeah, that's why my Grenadiers are in reserve to move straight into the town.
Well, whenever I get close, yeah. they'll just move up, occupy the position, and shoot out.
Yep. So anybody that's not played this kind of game before,
uh-huh.
this town is a whole town. It's not just 4 buildings.
Yep.
So you might see us moving buildings around.
Yeah.
That is perfectly legal.
Yeah.
The line of sight is actually the area, not the buildings.
Yeah, so it's a footprint.
Yes.
You know, so representation rather than recreation.
Yes.
Okay, well that...
I thought I better say that before somebody goes, why did CAD start moving yeah. the buildings around?
And I think my commander is going to move to here.
Okay, so next card.
Yes.
Brigadier 3.
Well, he'll just take an inspiration.
Yeah.
Just because... He's already activated his 2 units.
My CIC.
Uh-huh.
Now, I don't want to activate any units, so I'm going to gain another inspiration.
Mm-hmm. My
CIC.
He'll gain inspiration.
My Your Brigadier 1.
Who's already... Oh, no. He's taken a second. Yep.
Yeah. He's taken inspiration. So, what you'll see, your Brigadier 1.
Yep.
Is us taking a lot of inspiration at the moment. That's because the battle lines haven't engaged fully.
Yeah.
So they're being ordered quite early in a turn.
Mm-hmm. It's getting into position and then building up that reserve of inspiration to make sure they do what you want next round.
My CIC.
Another inspiration, I said.
Yep. Your Brigadier 2?
My Brigadier 2. He will obviously take inspiration. All of his units are activated, which is why it's important to put these down.
Yes. Your CIC?
Another inspiration.
And my Brigadier 1. Now, I'm left with a conundrum.
Yep.
I've already got 2 inspiration. Mm-hmm. He's a level 2 officer. Yep. Can't take any more. So, do I waste the card? The other option I'd have is rallying, but I haven't got any units that are damaged.
Yep. It would have been good for you if my cannons had actually hit, because then he's doing something valuable.
So, I've got choices. I can activate, but as we said, I'm not going to be within range of your infantry.
Yep.
In which case, I will...
Now, if you give them an order to move at the double, would that bring you in range?
Yes, but only if it's successful, and I'd have to spend inspiration tokens to make sure it goes off.
Yep.
And I'd have to then roll high enough with the slowdown for the river.
Yeah.
And then I'd
range.
Be in the river so for if I want to fall back. So, very clever, but I'm not doing that.
Okay. Just a tactical option.
But these guys are going to move, and they're going to move at the double.
Uh-huh. So, for a 4, they pass?
Yeah, they're grenadiers, so mm-hmm. they pass on a 4.
Okay.
So, they get to move an extra 1 inch.
Uh-huh.
For a grand total of 5. So...
Yeah, so the buildings are...
out of the way.
Yes.
So, that is the end of the round.
Uh-huh. Shuffle.
Clear activation tokens first.
Okay.
And then I get to roll for my reserves.
Ah. So how are we working this at the moment?
So if I pick, I've got 2 different kinds of brigades here.
Uh-huh.
You can make mixed brigades however you like.
Uh-huh.
The problem with mixing brigades is it can affect reserves.
Okay.
So my infantry would come on a 4+. My cavalry would come on a 4+.
Uh-huh.
My infantry would come on a 5+.
Uh-huh.
Because it's based on the slowest unit.
Yeah.
So if I had a heavy gun, the brigade would be even slower. But I'm going to pick my infantry because I'm in a defensive position. I don't need cavalry sallying out yet.
Okay.
They could dismount and provide me with skirmishers. Ooh, actually, skirmishers in the building. I'm going to go for my cavalry.
Okay.
So on a 4+.
All right, in the tray.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he gets them.
Gets them. So we put my Brigadier 3, 2 of his cards in that deck, and he'll arrive on the table the same as Justin's units did.
All right, there's your Brigadier 3.
I should have picked my infantry. I'd have got him in.
Okay, so I'll give this a quick shuffle. All right, well, that's the deck cut. So who do we have first?
Brigadier 3.
Ah, okay. My light cavalry are going to go for an order to move, but they're not going to spend the inspiration.
Okay.
So they're going to try and move 2d3 extra, but I need to pass their test first, yeah?
Yeah.
So Dragoon Regiment, Courage 5 up.
Yep.
Now, if I fail this, they take one of the disordered tokens or a wound token.
We call them just damage tokens because they represent morale damage, actual physical damage, but they can all be healed.
Yeah, and it's also maybe guys falling out of formation as well. All right. 4.
Ooh, that's good for me.
Good. Damn.
So they don't get to add the extra 2d3.
Yeah.
But they do have to do their move.
Yeah. So... there.
Yeah.
And I'll actually start turning a little bit, so I'll come back and go about there. Yeah. So we'll see how this works out for me. I think I've maybe went a little too far with them. The other ones will do it, but they will spend the token to carry the day.
So this is, for French, these are cavalry.
Uh-huh.
For British, the equivalent is known as heavy dragoons, which is unhelpful.
And they get to go an extra 3 inches. Excellent. So 3 inches onto my 12 is 15.
Ooh, they are really coming round, aren't they?
Yeah, so I can get it about there. Oof, really having to reach for this one. Cad, you may need to move my units in a little bit here.
Yeah, no, that's fine.
To about there, I think. That does mean I'm currently aiming at a river.
Yeah.
That might be okay because his... You took your cavalry, didn't you?
Yes.
I might take it in the flank, but we'll see.
No, I can only deploy up to the river.
Ah, so your deployment is behind the riverbank.
Otherwise, if I could deploy over here, it'd turn into a more of a standard battle.
Yeah. Okay. One thing I forgot.
you would definitely take it into the flank if I could deploy here, because they still get to charge 8 inches in line plus 2d3.
Ooh.
So they'd scream into you.
Yeah.
And if I did it with my heavy cavalry, you would not enjoy that. My CIC.
Uh-huh.
Now, once again, he's activating relatively early because the gun has some good shots.
Yeah.
So these light artillery can move.
And fire. Oof. Oh, dear.
So they're going to activate to there.
Yep.
He's only going to get 3 equipment dice because he's firing into your grenadiers. He gets 1 skill dice, and I know that 2 more activations are coming out for him.
Yep.
So I'm going to spend 2 of his inspiration again.
Yeah, just for that black die?
Yeah.
Because why would you not?
So 3s on the black, 6s on the white.
Uh-huh.
Nothing.
No.
Because that's just the way the dice want to roll.
Yeah, yeah.
That's all of his activations.
Uh-huh. Okay, new card. Your CIC again.
Not what I want.
Oof.
So he's taking another inspiration token.
Uh-huh. You're sassy again.
Okay.
Who shuffled this deck?
I think it was on purpose.
Anything else you want to do?
I've got my Brigadier 1 still. So I don't think there is anything else I want to do.
Okay.
Now we'll move him down to the gun.
Okay.
To boost its courage, if necessary. If it starts tangling with some grenadiers.
Yeah, maybe. New card?
Oh, yeah.
My Brigadier 1.
Yep.
Who is this gentleman here. So he's going to activate these.
Yep.
Am I in range to assault? Or can I even assault?
You can't assault while you're in column.
I've lined these guys up badly. All right, they're just going to go for a regular move. Now, if I go into the forest, do I get any cover for that?
You're not skirmishers, so no.
No. Okay, that's important. I think I'm going to have to take it on the chin for a round here. So what's going to happen is they're just going to go for a regular move. He's going to save his inspiration for maybe something later in the turn. So they've got 8 inches.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're just going to swing themselves around to about here. Should I have done a combined order? I should have, because I'm showing my flank to you. Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine.
All right. Pay the token for it.
Yep.
Because then they can just do it.
Yeah, because what was about to happen is my grenadiers were about to move through and shoot you in the flank.
Yeah, which would hurt.
Yeah.
But that'll do, because I'm now in range to shoot the cannon if I need to.
The other thing about charging stuff in a town is they get their courage save in combat. The thing you're charging.
Okay.
So it wouldn't matter so much with a gun, because that's what a single stand, you'd kill it.
Yeah.
But my grenadiers, if your grenadiers are charging mine, I get my save, and then I get to hit you back.
I see. Oof. Okay. Am I doing anything else?
Are you activating any of your other units? And
no.
An activation token by your grenadiers?
No, I am not activating anything else.
Would you like to move your Brigadier 1?
I need to make sure token.
Yeah.
And yes, he will move just about here.
Okay.
Just to stay in range. Or actually...
So he's not within 2 of the...
Yeah, I will move him within 2. Because he had the movement to do it. And that'll be helpful for me in case those grenadiers do shoot me.
They most certainly will.
Yep. Brigadier 3.
So you've got options now. Inspiration, or you can rally that off.
I think I'm in an okay position just to take the inspiration.
Yep.
Because there's nothing really here yet that I'm having to worry about.
There's no threat.
Yeah.
Okay. My Brigadier 1.
Uh-huh.
So he's got the 2 inspiration tokens, so I know that I don't want any more.
Yeah.
These guys can move... So I'll activate them. They can move 4 inches.
Yep.
The town doesn't slow you down because it represents all the roads and things that you can travel through, but it does affect my shooting.
Uh-huh.
So they move up to here.
Uh-huh.
In the town. They've activated, so I'll put that with them. You can move and fire in this game.
Mm-hmm.
So they're going to check ranges. They're outside of 4, unfortunately for me.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to spend one of his inspiration. Yep, one of his inspiration.
Okay.
To increase their shots skill by 1. I halve my shots because I'm in the town.
All right.
Because they're not able to form a proper line.
Yeah.
Don't count as firing in line, which is a problem for the British.
Okay.
Because they get a bonus to firing in line. So they're skill 4+. I spent the inspiration to go to 3+.
Mm-hmm.
And I get 5s on my equipment dice with only 2 shots. It's rounded up. The halving.
Rounded up. Okay.
So 5s on the whites.
Uh huh.
3s on the black.
2 hits.
2 hits.
Okay. So it's just the Grenadier's Courage, yeah?
Yep.
Grenadier Infantry Battalion is a 4+. Any minuses?
No minuses. If you'd left it with an exposed flank, you'd get -1.
Yeah. So the commander will jump in to make that a 3.
Yep.
I do take a point, but I don't lose a stand, which is important.
Yeah.
So, that there.
Then I'm going to check. They'd have to move a lot to get that in.
Mm-hmm.
No. Right, I'll leave it there.
Okay.
Brigadier 2, that's the infantry over here.
Yeah. They're all just going to move regularly.
Yep.
So, 8 inches.
Now, although Justin is declaring one at the same time, you don't actually have to.
Yeah,
you do one unit at a time.
Makes things handier. Whenever I know I'm doing the same with everything, and it's not really going to affect anything.
Yes.
It's easy.
So just in case your opponent does declare and then changes their mind, that is actually technically allowed because they didn't have to declare in the first place.
8 inches for this to here. I'm basically just trying to get these guys to form up so that they can turn and go after that Ford, but still be far enough back that he's not really going to get the jump on me.
Yeah.
This unit here.
Also, I don't want to cross the Ford because eventually your cavalry is going to make themselves in a position that they could rear or flank charge me.
My hope is my cavalry are just going to blitz on past you and ignore you. And then they swing down through into here and just give me a bad day.
That would give me a bad day.
Yeah, hopefully I can do it in time.
Next card?
Well, I need to put my activations down.
Yeah. Have you moved your officer?
I have not. So he's moving to here. Just staying to the front of
the columns.
Just so that he's definitely in range.
So it's my cavalry.
Ah. This is where things get interesting. Because I'm putting a lot of threat. Yeah, right there.
So I'm going to move on in line.
Uh-huh.
So cavalry in line only move 8 inches.
Mm-hmm.
So there's my heavy, which are heavy dragoons in my case.
Yep.
And my lights. Moving on to there. And then what I've hoped that's done is made it so you won't want to come round the river.
Yeah. Well, what I might do is I might reform.
Mm-hmm.
And just try and swing myself so that I can actually get a frontal face on your cavalry.
Yep.
Because then it's cavalry v cavalry. It's a decent fight. Just who gets the charge.
It is who gets the charge at that point. Brigadier 2,
this gentleman again. Yep, so he can quite happily take another inspiration. Waiting for my CIC, speak of the devil.
Yeah, he had to come out eventually.
Yep, now I have been sitting quietly waiting to do this. So, both my artillery guns have a line to those guys.
Yeah.
Getting 3 bases. You're in the town.
So you get -1 to hit.
Yep.
And I get +1 to my saves, which is negated by your -1 because your artillery.
Which is totally fine, but it means I'm getting a good
Before you fire, don't forget your artillery is so small, they only hit on 6s.
Yeah.
The -1 to hit takes them above, so I get another +1 to my save.
Yeah. I'm okay with that.
I'm okay with that,
but what I will do is I will move the first gun 6 inches.
Yeah.
Because if I can get into canister and get on the side, that could be even better.
Yeah. I'm also at an additional -1 because of the side.
Yes. So, 1 set, all 6s.
Yep.
Ooh. Ooh, 2.
Okay.
I'll take that.
So, I've got +3, basically.
Uh-huh.
No, +2.
+2, -2,
so I'm on 4s.
Uh-huh.
And I spend...
Inspiration?
1 inspiration.
Uh-huh. To make it 3s?
To make it 3s. I'm then going to throw in the officer.
To make it 2s.
To make it 2s.
Okay.
And then roll double 1. I got a double 4.
All right. Second verse, same as the first.
Yeah. So these are very, very light guns. They cost only slightly more than a stand of infantry. Yours are 33 points to your infantry's 21.
Yeah. So activate it. Same shot again.
Yeah. Not using any inspiration for your skill. You don't have to. It won't make any difference. You've got minus one.
Yeah.
So and you'll still be a minus one on your equipment. Oh, God, just
two again. On point today, lads. On point.
So I'm going to do the same trick.
Make it twos. But I am making you spend that resource.
Yes.
Which is fine. my CIC is then going to activate this unit.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to go for a combined order, spend the inspiration to make it pay off. So they're going to move 8.
Yeah.
And then rotate. So I'll just line them up on there. My artillery might be slightly in my way here, if I've done this wrong. Might be okay.
So the reason
might be okay.
The reason we base them three deep is when you form line, you contract.
Yeah.
Which is correct. You move into close order, so everybody contracts down.
Yeah. I'm going to move him just out of the way.
Yeah.
So he'll be standing here. Same again for this unit, with the inspiration. You know what? Screw it. They're just going to go right behind their buddies. About there, I think. For the 8. No, it's further back. It's here. So they're going to contract into there. Which again is okay because I'm going to be able to shimmy them where I want them after this. And both those units are gone as well, which is fine. Don't
yep.
knock your units just in. Okay.
So if you're a bit confused as well about the artillery, we never want units not to be able to hit.
Yeah.
So as soon as a hit roll goes above 6, the opponent just gains +1 to their save.
Yeah.
Otherwise, small artillery pieces, you'd be like, well, what's the point of having?
You see, my hope is next turn, I'm going to be moving to about here, getting you in the flank mm-hmm. with canister at short range.
Yeah, that would be unpleasant.
Yeah. CIC again. So he's just going to start grabbing inspiration.
Brigadier 3, that's my cav. They've already activated, which I didn't put the activation token on.
Uh-huh. Yeah, so the deployment counts as their activation then?
Yes, it does.
Okay. And then, what we got?
Brigadier 1.
Yeah.
Who so
could take an inspiration, or he can start getting stuff into position for himself.
I'm checking.
Oh, no. What have I done?
Because you're just outside of 10.
Uh-huh.
But I won't hit the water. I get 1.5 inches to the water.
Uh-huh.
So I've got half of my move left.
Uh-huh.
So 4, 2, I get another inch and a little bit. So
I think you're just shy.
There. So I'm going to spend the inspiration
uh-huh.
to make them advance.
D3.
I'm not going to roll it because I only want to go
a little more. Yeah, you're in range. And for arc of fire, grenadiers are out.
No, I'm going for your gun.
Oh, I understand that. I was checking to see if the grenadiers were perhaps closer if you were in arc.
And I'd have to fire at the grenadiers.
Mm-hmm.
I see.
Sneaky tactics.
So while the guns are exposed, you can't shoot guns unless they're the closest target.
Yes.
Which is why, while they were exposed at the moment, I was like, I'll go for it.
Yeah.
I get 5 shots.
Uh-huh.
I am firing in line.
Yep. Important thing to note. These are 2 separate units, so you can only target one of them, yeah?
Yeah, I can only target the closest gun.
Yeah.
So I can only kill one.
Yeah.
So they're skill 5, they go down to 4 because they're British firing in line.
Uh-huh.
The equipment dice is 5s. I do get -1 on everything because you're a light gun.
Okay.
So 6s on the black, 5s on the whites.
Okay, hit me. Oh, God.
That is pleasant.
Oh, God, why you do this?
It's 5...
I think it was 5s on the... Well,
I'll remove one of the... Oh, it's. I said it was 5s on the black.
Yeah.
Oh. If I didn't, correct me and I'll feel sad.
All right, so 3 hits. Saves on my artillery.
Artillery it's battery. It's in their flank, Justin.
Because
of the way the flank arc works.
Aye, because it's that angle. Yep,
yeah.
You've definitely got them in the flank. So they're on a 6.
Yep.
And it's 3. And they have a resolve of 2. Inspiration and commander would make it a 4.
But if they fail it, there's you get a risk roll. On the commander.
I'm going to go for it.
Fair enough.
Inspiration plus commander. fours.
Yeah.
Watch me make none of them.
Oh, that's what I wanted.
It is dead, and you get to roll for the commander.
CIC, in fact.
Oh, God.
Six.
No.
No.
Oh, God.
So guns are support units.
Yeah.
So luckily you don't have to test for his whole...
Yeah, everything around him.
His whole brigade.
You know, the detachment that he just went, no, you brigadier. No, these are mine. You go work with those grenadiers there. That's fine.
So that was good for me.
Yeah.
I might as well activate these as well.
Yeah.
So they're just going to follow up behind.
Yeah. Now, they do walk on the forge, so they would
full
not
movement,
be slowed.
But I don't need them to move up any further, and they can't shoot.
Yeah, okay.
But what I wanted them in is in support of the other unit.
Yeah.
So we're using this as a very shallow river, which is why we can ford it.
Yeah.
Why we can ford it and why we can cross it without massive modifiers.
Yeah.
So I better tell people before they were like, Cad, why is your unit running off into the river?
My CIC. He'll grab an inspiration.
Brigadier one.
He will.
Grenadiers are under his command.
Yeah. But he will just grab an inspiration.
Oh, he's not on a rally.
Not yet. Because
fair enough.
The inspiration, if they take another point of damage, you know, it's the whole thing of healing them. They can they can stand a bit more.
Yep.
But if he needs to, he can then just auto remove two.
Yep. Right. So that is the end of the turn.
Yep.
I will roll for my infantry.
Uh huh. On
fives.
On a five. Okay.
No.
Denied. All right. Draw.
Okay. Come on. Not that.
CIC. Yes. Okay. 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 Okay, okay, okay. Now watch this. Watch this. So E is going to go full six.
Yeah.
And try to get out of that arc of fire of yours.
Yeah.
Because that's bad. But he's going to try and make sure he's within his eight. He is. And he can get two stands.
If you're within eight, you get three equipment dice because you're firing canister.
Right, so it doesn't matter if it stands at that point.
Because canister doesn't pass through the ranks.
Ah.
You just generate three equipment dice.
That's fine. So he'll do that into this unit.
Yep.
So looking at sixes, yeah?
Yeah. No inspiration? You don't have to.
No. Oof, glad I didn't. Four twos.
Yeah.
But that's a bit better now. And then what I'm also going to do, so I'm going to go for a combined order on these.
Mm-hmm.
For them to turn, move, or did I already form them? They're already formed.
So I'm assuming you did it to gain extra movement, but you don't have to. It confused me.
Yeah. Well, I mean, like, they can move four.
They're going to get within eight.
Yeah. But if they get the additional, how far apart are we? So if I need to get within four, is there. So that would
be
six. So I'd need two on the D3.
Yep.
That's worth it. So inspiration for additional movement.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see if I can get that. No, I only get one extra. So it's 5 inches. So they're all up to there. And they will just unload into you while you're in the river.
Yeah. So luckily I'm infantry, so it's not providing a modifier to my courage at all. If I was cavalry, I'd get no save at all.
Yeah, but that is seven of the finest each.
Yeah, I'm not so keen on that.
Yeah, so this is not my regulars. Cavalry, not my dragoons, not my grenadiers, my regulars. So it's fives and fives.
Yep.
I was hoping to go to fives and fours for range. And because I'm French, I get nothing special.
You got an inspiration there on your Brigadier 1. This is a separate roll, so you can throw his inspiration in to make it fours and fives.
I'll do that for the skill. You still have stuff to activate.
I've got everything to activate.
Exactly. So I'm going to hold that inspiration there just in case those dragoons or my grenadiers take a shot.
Yeah.
Because being able to throw an extra bit on the save, definitely worth it. So fives and fives.
Yeah.
Ooh, hello.
That's a fair few.
That many. Six. So six saves with no modifier.
No, so they're on fives normally.
Uh-huh.
I'll throw in him to make it fours. The inspiration, because he's within 12, to make it threes.
Okay. Oh, God.
Oh, no. That's three gone. So that's one stand.
Uh-huh. D6.
One left over. And if you kill my Brigadier 1 now, I'll be really sad.
Oh, please, please. Dice gods, I know you're up there. This once.
Not no! Bad. I thought it was going to be the same as Rob when he killed my Bromhead. Everybody laughing, cheering.
Yeah, if anybody wasn't keeping an eye on the Facebook, we actually played Jerry's Works Drift a little while back.
Yes.
But no, that's fair enough. It's a stand, and I'll take that.
Yeah. I'd rather you didn't.
Wow. And then, so this unit's going to act as well, but I'm needing to move my CIC out of the way first. So he's going to go to here. And they're just going to move regularly for 4. Mm-hmm. So, 4-4. Stay about here. Am I within 8 there? I wonder. Because I might be able to get some of my unit on you.
You can pre-measure. Eight.
Yeah. So I've got 2 stands in range. And 2 that can see, I would say. Or can that third one see? From the middle, yeah, I can see right through. So 3
That's
stands.
That's fine. I'm happy with 3 stands.
Okay. So 3 and 3, 5s and 5s.
Yep.
Still regulars. So, 2 more?
Rolling very well.
Above the odds?
I'm going to throw my officer again.
All right.
So 4s. Oh, failed 1, which is not good.
Yeah. So is that a stand?
Yes, a stand.
Oof. So roll for the officer?
Yep.
Close, but no cigar. Or is it cigarette because they're French?
Cigarillo. Or is that Spanish?
Yeah. No, I think that's Spanish. But that was worth it. So I need to start laying out my activations. So that's done. That's done.
And your guns.
That's done.
Next.
Yep. CIC. He will be grabbing some inspiration.
Brigadier 1. Now, in his first activation, I'm going to rally.
Okay. So this unit.
Rally that unit. I want to get it's right a D3 return of damage, but I can only return a stand if I roll what I need for that stand.
Right, and can you feed inspiration into this?
I can, but I've spent it all.
Yeah.
So I need a 3 plus, basically.
Uh-huh.
Because it's a D3.
3. You got it. So stand back. So I assume that's him basically calling for reserves from the back line?
So the men might not be dead. Mm. So they might be just milling around and less effective in the regiment. He's going, come on, lads, steady. Yeah. And at that point, they're like, well, he's quite calm, so why shouldn't we be? He almost got shot twice. next card. When you rally, that's the only thing you can do. And it's D3 on any unit within your command range that belongs under you.
Yeah, so I roll the D3 and I can spread that?
Yes. But obviously, if you want to return a stand, you need to spend the 2.
Yeah.
My CIC.
Ooh, that's good for you.
Yeah. So actually, he's got to get involved in this mess.
What, this mess?
Yeah.
This is not a mess. This is tactical brilliance.
So he's going to fire the gun.
Mm-hmm.
I believe you're within 8.
Yeah, I will be. Yeah, definitely. Canister.
So, yeah, canister. 6 is on the white.
Ooh,
one hit.
Just the one. I will throw my Brigadier 1 in there.
Yeah, might as well.
So that's Grenadiers. I should really just lay these out. Courage 4 to begin with.
Yeah, minus 1 for artillery, plus 1 for your officer.
So
4s.
4s. And they can obviously take that without losing a stand because they've got resolve of 3. Oh, yeah, they don't care. I do find it funny how often the Grenadiers just don't care. She's like, nah, don't care, not today.
I think I'm going to advance onto the riverbed.
Oh.
No, I'm not, because I'd rather you try and charge me in here. I'm not going to be that stupid.
I don't know, because getting to fire in line with your full 3 stands.
I know, but then you won't be able to charge me across the river easily. And I'll have got the first shot and you're already damaged. Yes, you are correct. That would be better.
I assume you're just shimmying out an inch. Yeah. You're outside the town, just on the bank.
Yep.
Okay.
So I now get my full shots.
Yeah.
And I get the plus 1 to my skill for firing in line.
Yeah.
So Blacks are threes.
And this is why I saved that inspiration.
Yeah. Blacks are threes, whites are fives. Oh, actually, they might not be fives. It doesn't matter. I only rolled fives because I think I might be within four. Doesn't matter.
Okay.
That's three hits.
Three hits. So I'll send them to threes. But there is three there. But that would be twos. So yeah, commander. So yeah. Brigadier one and an inspiration to make it twos on three dice.
Go on, triple one.
No!
Well, one, one.
They take one. But that's okay, because resolve of three.
Yeah.
So that'll do. I will take that all day long.
And then he will move into this gap.
Uh-huh.
And that will be the last of my activations.
Uh-huh. Next.
Brigadier one.
Ooh.
Now, he's already activated once, hasn't he?
Yes, he has. Because he got these guys.
You can check back through to see how many times he rallied.
Yes.
So.
Yeah, and rallying doesn't count as a unit's activation.
No.
Good.
So.
Oof.
Turn them.
But. For your angle, these guys are still closer.
No, I'm not going for your gun, I'm going for your grenadiers.
Oh, I see. And that'll be a flank shot, yeah?
Yeah.
But you're outside of four, which is good. So, eight dice. And then what? Four's on the blacks, five's on the whites?
Yep. One more.
Dismay sting. Go for it.
Ooh.
Ooh, that stings. So that's six.
So you normally courage four, flank shot, courage five.
Yeah, inspiration to bring it back to fours.
Officer?
It's threes, it's not good enough. On twos, it's worth it, but on threes, no.
Yeah.
Especially because 1 point away from losing a stand.
Yeah.
So fours.
Ooh, that's a whole stand.
That's a whole stand.
And it would have been even if you'd thrown your officer in, so you made the right call.
Yeah. So, whole stand goes, and they keep this damage.
Yeah. And in which case, the next thing I'm going to do is these guys are going to push forward to here.
Oh, my.
And discharge in your face.
Oof. This is just horrible stuff right here.
It's always horrible when somebody...
This is what happens because I blew my load early.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's always horrible when somebody discharges in your face. And we'll be good later. So, fours and fours?
Yeah, yeah.
So, only three hits?
Three hits. That's my regular, so they're on fives.
Yeah.
Officer to make it fours, but that's my CIC. I don't want to do that, so I'm just going for fives. I save one, so yep. I do lose a stand, but I don't have to roll for my officer.
No.
Which makes me happy. So
and he's going to go there in between. Oh, he only needs to be within 2 inches, so I actually need to be getting as close as I am. Because he wants to be within. Yeah.
Okay. New card.
New card. Brigadier 2. This gentleman here.
Over here. So, has he had any yet this round?
No, I don't believe it has. I'll check for you.
Yeah.
CIC. No, you only activated your CIC.
That's fine. So I'm just going to grab an inspiration on him. So it's only my CIC has went.
Mm-hmm. He's gone twice, your CIC.
Okay.
So you've still got Brigadier 1 and Brigadier 3.
Yeah. Well, Brigadier 1 with 2, that's going to be very useful for me.
Yep. Brigadier 3, your cav.
All right, so your cavalry hasn't activated either. So what I want you to do, Cad,
yeah,
is these guys are just going to go for a move, and they're just going to be swinging around this way.
So and they up will, to the edge of the board?
Yeah. And
you got the full of that.
Well, not up to the edge of the board.
Where would you like them?
I want them just swinging around here so that I'm lining along as soon as I can get straight.
They can
edge.
Literally go wherever you want.
Yeah.
So there?
Yeah, there. And I'll be spending an inspiration to combine order to put them into line.
Yeah.
Just so that I've got some frontage there.
Yep.
The other unit of cavalry are going to activate as well. And what they're going to do is they're going to swing in behind them And I will have to roll for them, and they're my light.
If they lose us, if they fail it, they'll lose a stand.
They will not turn, but they will swing in behind. Just so that, again, next round, they can turn, and then that gives me enough time, I think. Because I think trying to charge cavalry across this river is going to be a problem for you.
Yes. I need another activation token.
Oh, sorry.
There we go. And do you want him close to them?
Of course, within two of both. Just in case something goes skew. Yeah, that's grand.
It might do.
So they've ran into a cornfield. This is totally fine. I feel more comfortable with that now. Just my line feels anchored.
My CIC. Now, how many times has he come out? Once.
That is one good thing to note, is the discard pile is open information.
Yes, sorry. If you wonder why I keep looking through it.
Yeah.
So he's going to gather an inspiration.
Okay. New card then?
Yep.
My brigade one. Perfect. So, tactical advice here. Everything here has activated.
Mm-hmm.
He's not activated before, so he's just going to grab an inspiration.
And then, I know what you're doing with him.
I'm buffing up to get the better rally.
Mm-hmm.
Because as it stands, if I can get 3 on that rally dice, I will get a full stand back, but yes, I still keep the 2 damage versus just maybe getting 2 or 1 damage off.
Yeah. Well, and if you fail it, you're going to clear off the damage anyway.
Yep. CIC. How many times has he went? Well,
he's
everything's
gone twice.
Activated. So, yeah, that's fine. He'll just take an inspiration there because everything's gone around him. Actually, he won't. He'll try for a rally roll on the Grenadiers.
Thinking that.
Because he can do that as well. So,
D3. If you get a 3, that'll be happy for you.
Yeah. What? No, it's just 1.
So, but you do get to remove 1 of the damage.
I will take it.
Brigadier 2, this gentleman.
Yeah.
He can't have 3 inspiration taken.
Oh, sorry. Damn it. So 1 of those would have moved, and he would be taking an inspiration now.
Yeah.
Or no.
You'd have moved all of them.
Yeah.
Do you want to do that? It wouldn't affect what I'm doing, because...
Yeah, well, what I would have been doing last time is moving and combining to turn with 2 of them and rolling for the other.
Yeah, that's fine.
So I'll move and turn with this one with the inspiration. Damn it.
You gave me your tape as well, I think.
Yeah. So I think tape out here and turn. And here and turn. So, Kat, if you can line those guys up for me.
Yeah.
And then the last one I need to test for. So it's on a 5. They get it?
Yep.
So they'll move up to the same area and turn as well, which is exactly what I want.
You know when you said you weren't going to deploy down here?
Aye. it's the way the battle has went. You know, what was it Sun Tzu said? No battle plan survives first contact with the enemy.
Yeah.
Well, this is Justin's game. Doesn't survive first contact with Cad.
Do you want him in the front or down by the side?
Down by the side, please.
And then you're going to grab your second...
Yeah, so...
So what for your first inspiration?
You would grab that after having spent the 2 earlier in the round. Sorry for that. A little bit of retcon. But it's nice to have an opponent that lets you do that.
Well, it wouldn't have affected what I did at all. So,
yeah.
My CIC.
Uh-huh.
So that's his final activation. Mm-hmm. I can't activate anything else.
Nope.
I don't want to rally anything.
Yeah, you don't need to rally any. Well, actually...
He can still be rallied.
Yeah, because they're down a stand.
But I don't want to do that. I'll take a token. Mm-hmm. Brigadier 3. Now, these have activated, and exactly the same as Justin did there. I know they've activated.
Yeah, so you can take your time.
Brigadier 3. Well, it doesn't get to take much time.
Well...
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do something surprising.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to dismount.
Oh. Okay.
So I move 8 inches.
Uh-huh.
These models become dismounted skirmishers.
Ah, so that's why you put those there.
Yeah. And then you put... Currently, a stand behind them just to remind you what the unit was.
Yeah.
Like, that stand has no impact on play. They only go 1 for 1.
Mm-hmm.
So those guys are going to fire into you because they're armed with muskets.
Are you within it?
I am within 8, because that's what I measured. I was supposed to be within 8.
Just to be sure you've got yourself where you want yourself.
Yeah.
That's fine.
All right.
Now, charging skirmishers, good or bad?
Really bad.
Really bad idea?
For me.
Oh, right.
No, it's really good. Okay. The benefit is you shouldn't be able to make it across this river. You got 8 inches of movement now, halved to 4.
6 goes to 3, and then 2d3.
Yeah, see, that is
also halved.
That is a long distance to be getting across.
Yeah.
That's what I was planning anyway. Plus, I'd be able to fire, closing fire, and you've got no save because you're going through the river.
Mm.
So, I've got 4 stands. Skirmishers always halve the number of dice, so they would only get 4 dice.
Uh-huh.
2 equipment, 2 skill. Mm-hmm. They're actually only skill 5 plus, equipment 6 plus, because their muskets are lighter. They're not as effective. So, whites are on 6, that's on 5s.
Yeah.
1 hit on your cav.
Commander will jump in on that.
Yeah, to give him a 3 up.
That's my heavies. So, cavalry regiment, yeah? Yep.
Yep.
Special heavy. So 4 goes to 3. They're fine.
And then this unit.
Yep.
Is probably going to do the same. So 8 inches of movement takes them to there.
Uh huh.
And then wheel around and come across.
Ah, so you're just plugging the gap.
Yep.
Now, Cad, from line, I'm forming column, can I form it from left or right?
Yes. Do you mean, can you form it either way?
Yeah, can I form it so I'm going this way?
Yes. And he spent his inspiration to do that, otherwise I'd have had to test.
Yep.
So, for me, the heavy dragoons and the light dragoons are exactly the same.
Uh-huh.
So,
go for it.
5s and 6s.
Yep.
1 hit.
Okay. Throw the officer in. It's still the heavies?
Yep.
Okay, so for a 3, it's fine. So... totally fine.
Right. That is his activation.
Uh-huh.
Brigadier 1.
Okay. So this is his second activation for the round.
Yes.
He's going to rally.
Yeah.
Put an inspiration in.
Yeah, so you still need a 3 to return. For people at home, he still needs a 3 to return the unit.
Yes. So there'd be no point throwing the inspiration in.
Yes, there is, because you get a plus 1, so you don't on a 2 or a 3 on a d3.
Ah, I see. Okay, I'll throw it in, so it's... So I need a 2 on the dice to return the stand.
You need 3 plus, because it's a d3.
Yeah. Okay.
Or you could just roll it naturally.
And do
technically
everything.
Get 4 and do that.
Yeah, and that's these boys.
Yeah.
So that is looking a bit more healthy for the next round, I think.
So as you can see, if a general concentrates on a unit...
Yeah.
Which is good for me because he's lost momentum. That unit didn't actually activate this turn.
No, they did not.
So, yes, he returned them to full strength, but because he had to return them to full strength, they didn't do anything.
Yeah.
He says, hoping this is a good card. It's Brigadier 3, so he could rally off that damage or take the inspiration for the auto pass.
He'll just rally off the damage, so give it here.
Yeah.
And that'll be another round.
Yeah, so I get to roll for my infantry. They now get plus 1.
So 4s?
4s.
Oof. 3. No, denied. Right, so shuffly.
Yeah.
And get all of our activations off. Okay, keep going.
Right. Please be me. Ooh.
Oh, no. Oh, wow. This is bad. So he's got a CIC.
Do I?
Everything here can go.
Do I blow my load?
Oh, do you? Do you wanna?
It's a really hard choice, because the more I activate now, that gives you more chance yourself to build inspiration.
Yeah, and also don't forget.
Well, I'm not gonna kill anything. I don't think.
You see, this is why I think the rallying at the end of the round there, just getting those grenadiers back into formation is crucial for me.
I was really hoping you weren't going to do that and that you were going to really come in and fight me, because although I might have taken some damage, I'd have been able to kill you this turn. No, I'm going to have to.
Okay.
And activate the gun first and then go from there, depending on what gun does. So it's going to fire a canister into your...
Grenadiers.
Your grenadiers.
All right.
So that's 1 hit.
One hit, okay. Because it's only the one hit, I'll throw the commander in to make it threes.
Fours, because it's minus one for artillery.
Yes, fair point.
Oh. So that's 1 point.
Yeah, I'll take a point of damage.
Ouch. I will fire
your own grenadiers. Yeah, they're within four.
They are within four.
Yeah.
So I'll use one inspiration to fire three of each. The skill dice is going to be down to threes. Mm-hmm. No, twos, because they're British firing line, mm-hmm. plus one for the inspiration. Fours on the white.
Go.
So oh, no. Four hits.
Oof.
No modifier.
Yeah.
So four ups.
Four ups. With four of them, not worth it to risk a commander. So fours.
That's why I wanted that stand.
One stand, yeah. So this one. And the wind goes too, which is fine.
I will then...
Those poor grenadiers, they're just getting so beat up.
I will then... Fire these guys into you.
And you've got my flank.
I've got your flank. So that's eight dice. Fours for my skill.
Fives for equipment.
Yeah, I'm debating putting the inspiration in.
Are you trying to vaporize them this turn?
I don't think I can, but I can drop them down to a point that you'll want to start rallying them again, is what I'm hoping. So I will put in the inspiration.
Okay. So black dice on threes.
Black dice on threes. Ugh. Oh, that is not what I wanted to see. One hit.
Oh, I'll throw the commander in.
Yeah.
Make it threes.
Yep. Yeah. Fours, because you've got been hit in the flank.
Yep. Damn it. So I take a point.
Yep.
Pop that there.
And then I might as well, because I've got to the point where I've...
You've committed.
Committed.
Yeah.
No, I'm not going to fire. And the reason I'm not firing is because if I fire, you will charge me.
Yes. I was hoping you would make that mistake.
So, that's because that could come up. Now, the downside is you know I've gone.
Yes. Is it my CIC now?
Yeah.
Okay. So, I'm going to keep my powder dry. I'm going to start gathering up some inspiration. Because that really hurt me at the start of this round, not having any.
Yes.
Three. That's he's, over on your side there, isn't it?
Yeah, he's going to generate some inspiration.
Okay.
Brigadier two, that's this gentleman here.
Yeah, his gents are going to start marching forward.
They can gain an inspiration at the moment if you want.
I'm okay because I'm not going to spend it, so I'm going to move them, gain it.
Okay. So just the straight four?
Just straight four. Because you're going to have to start dealing with waves of them. So even if you kill the first wave, the second's going to come through, then the next, then the next.
Yeah.
Now it's the one bad thing for me is those river crossings.
Yes.
Trying to get in there.
I'm assuming you want to be within two of the lead element.
Yes, definitely. Because we will eventually come to blows.
Only if the game goes badly.
Flip.
No, that's not what I want either.
Okay, that I can work with. So Brigadier 1, because I know you've gone. Mm-hmm. I'm just going to grab that.
Yep.
CIC for you. So grab ease in that. Here. Yep, that's fine. Next card. CIC for me.
Oof. Still got one more activation after this.
Yeah, and you've gone with most of your stuff, so grab another inspiration.
Brigadier 1.
For you, so that's this gentleman here.
Yep.
Grabbing inspiration. Useful to have.
Yeah.
Your CIC.
How many times has he gone? That's the third, isn't it?
Yeah. I think he did most of your activations, didn't he?
Yeah, one, two. And the first card. Three. If I don't go now. No, he's going to have to go.
Okay. What's he going to activate?
That unit there. I can't hold off hoping that Brigadier 1 comes out.
Yeah.
So he's going to discharge their muskets in your face.
So eight dice.
Eight dice.
Yep.
I will spend his inspiration to make it threes on the black, fours on the white.
Two.
Four. Threes on the black.
Right. Okay. So four saves into that unit. No minuses, but they're on fives, so I'll spend... two.
Yeah.
And make it threes. Good shout.
Yes.
All saved.
Right.
Yep.
These aren't activating under him, so that's fine.
Yeah, yeah.
Predict one. That's not what I want.
You could have held.
Yeah.
Could have held the line.
I'd have to gain another inspiration.
Okay. Brigadier 3.
It's not going well.
Mm-hmm.
They're both going to fire.
Yeah. 4 and 4.
Yeah. So,
okay.
So 5s and 6s. One hit.
Okay. Throw the commander in.
Yeah.
To make it a...
3?
I think it's... Yeah, it's a 3. Huh. Yep, fine.
And then the lights... Mm-hmm. It's the same, so that was 2 hits.
Yeah, so throw them in again.
Yep.
For 3. Or no, yeah, it's heavy, so 3s. Nope. Totally fine. That's fine. Didn't even need him.
Right.
Flip. Brigadier 3. Right. Now I'm going to try and do something a little bit janky.
You're going to try and charge me?
No. No, no, no. So, that's his first, isn't it?
Yep.
So he's going to gain an inspiration, and he'll do his weird thing in a minute, whenever I can confirm my combined order.
Brigadier 3.
Okay. So he's spending his inspiration to do a combined order and reform.
Yep.
So they're going to reform into line to come
line?
This way.
Yeah, column.
Column, sorry. And then they are going to move and try and swing themselves through this gap to here. So 7 inches total brings them to there.
Yeah.
And I'm hoping for an early activation next round so that they can maybe sneak right through here.
Yeah.
We'll see if it works. The other guys are going to form. Yep, they're going to reform and do nothing else. Because do you get a ranged attack with your cavalry?
Only if you're dismounted.
Only if you're dismounted. That's okay. I suppose whenever you're on the horse, saber's out.
Yeah.
But that's okay for that. So that's done. New card?
Where would you like him to go?
Keep him closer to these, because these still have to activate.
No, they don't.
Hmm?
I've used all my actions.
Oh, denied. Brigadier 1? Let me just check my measurements. So I've got one more in my CIC, yeah?
Yeah.
All right, so he is going to rally them.
Yeah.
Using his inspiration.
Mm-hmm.
So it's D3
yeah.
plus 1.
They're yes. all back.
Everything's back. That's perfect. And I've still got my CIC to get stuff activating.
Yep. CIC.
Okay, so, charge here.
Yep.
Do I have a CIC left in there, or what's left in there?
It'll be Brigadier 2.
Okay. So, yep. Charge here.
Yep.
Because you can't fire because
nope.
of that. I'm within 4.
Because I've activated.
So we'll go straight in.
Yep.
And do we bump across, yeah? To maximize
yes.
frontage? So that's 7 dice.
On 5s.
Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And everything I hit is dead.
Yep. Okay. 1 stand per hit.
Okay, and you've got 4 there. Not a bean. No, one. Okay.
Which you do get to roll for my officer for.
Okay. For 6. No.
No.
You now get to attack back with 3.
3.
And you're on...
5s as well.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to drop it to 4s.
Oh.
Because if I kill one stand,
yeah,
I'll push
I'm
you
repulsed.
Back. One stand. You
yep.
need to spend the inspiration there.
All right, so one of my stands goes, and you don't get to roll for my officer because he's outside.
Nope.
But I'm repulsed D3, yeah?
Yep.
Yeah. 2. So back 2 inches from here. I think that's about it there. Well, that's okay. It was worth a go.
It was. So they've activated, but you've
yep.
got the rest to go.
Yeah, I still have the rest to go. So activation's done there. Next thing I'll activate is the cannon
mm-hmm.
is going to go for a shot into the flank of these guys.
Yep. You within 8.
I'm outside of 8, but the line will
give you 3 anyway.
Yep. So, 3 white dice, 1 black dice.
Yep.
All 6s.
6s.
One something, baby.
Yes.
One.
One.
So I will throw my officer in.
Plus one, minus one.
Yep. So fives.
Yep. Six. Didn't even need them, but it was worth it. My grenadiers, because you're now in the open, are just going to unload into
yep.
you. So it's six dice.
Yep.
And they are fours on the black.
And then going up to fours on the white.
Down to fours on the white?
Within four.
Oh, yeah. So fours and fours.
Yep.
This should hurt. That'll be two.
So I'll throw the officer in to make him threes for the save.
Double
Ooh,
one.
Snake eyes.
Two damage. You're still okay because it's only two damage.
Yeah.
All right. So this unit here is going to move and fire.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna be wheeling slightly to about here, and just make sure I'm not exposing my flank to you.
Mm-hmm.
There, everything into them.
Yep.
In the flank. As everybody in the flank. So I would say no, no, no. So four in the flank.
Okay. So roll them separately.
Yeah. So I'll do the flank shots first.
Yeah.
Fours and fives?
Yep.
Or, sorry, regulars?
No, fives and fives.
Fives and fives, yep. I will take that for three.
So, mark that as three I've got to take in the flank. I have to make the decision on whether to throw my general in
yep.
before I make saves.
Yep, and then I've got three more sets, fives and fives, outside yep. of the flank. That'll be two more.
So that's five hits. I will throw my general and the inspiration.
Mm-hmm. Taking yourself to a three.
And
then a four on the flank shots. So three shots on
no,
four.
It's four plus, uh-huh. three plus, two plus for the straight on shots.
Oh, yes.
Threes for the flanks. So the three flanks.
Uh-huh.
Oh, so two uh-huh. so far. The two in the front.
Are okay.
Oh, fine. So that's two. So I'm left with one and I lost the stand.
Yep.
And you get to test for my CIC.
Just the once, yeah?
Yep.
Okay, and...
Ah! Yes.
Death.
Right.
That's bad for you.
That's really bad for me. Luckily, I can promote somebody else straight away to CIC.
Yeah, because we're at the end of the round.
So
the last thing to happen in this round is my Brigadier 2.
Yeah.
And I will pop an inspiration over here.
I'm getting carried away because it's getting stressful. The first thing I do is I increase one of these to my CIC. So it'll be Brigadier 1. So uh-huh. if you remove one CIC card, because he's only level 2.
Uh-huh.
And then I get to roll, not yours. You can remove your CIC card if you like.
I just saw CIC and went, yay, it's got... Oh, yeah.
Then I'm going to roll to see what my new officer is. If I yes. roll a 1, he's nothing. He doesn't exist yet.
Yep.
They're still trying to sort it out. If I roll a 2 to a 4,
yep.
level it's a level 1. If I roll a 5, he's a level 2. And if I roll a 6, he's a level 3.
Oof.
Come on, 6.
5.
He's level two, so he's the same level as he was.
So basically, I can just put your CIC card back in.
No, because he isn't a level 3.
Ah, yeah. So it's... Which of your Brigadiers is it?
Brigadier 1.
Brigadier 1.
He's still in there as a level 2 anyway, so
yes.
it's fine. And he comes back within 2 inches of any of his units.
That's fine.
So effectively, Brigadier Black Pudding has become Major General Black Pudding. Spotted Dick is dead. And Jim Ladd is now...
See, sometimes food just goes out of fashion.
It does. You know,
it's like generals, they go out of fashion.
Yeah, now you should be sticky. Brigadier Sticky Toffee Pudding. Well, Colonel Sticky Toffee Pudding is
Colonel Sticky Toffee Pudding. Yeah, I'd follow that man to death.
I need to roll for my reserves.
Yep.
So it was 4, now it's 3, and I bet you I'll get a 2 after the last couple of rounds.
4.
4. So
they do come in.
Brigadier 3 goes into the deck now. Brigadier 2, because... Brigadier Haggis, because he's leading the Highlanders.
Right, and he's only 2 cards, yeah?
He's only 2 cards.
Right.
But Brigadier Haggis is on the table. Brigadier 3, that's not the one I want.
Perfect! My cavalry is going to activate and try and sneak through your lines.
Yep.
So, basically what's going to happen is, from where we are, these guys are activating and swinging right through as far as they can. They're going to order a test to see if they get an additional 2d3.
Yep.
Because this is that big flank maneuver. So come on. 4.
They fail because they're cav.
Cavalry regiment. Heavy cavalry. Courage 4.
Skill.
Skill? Oh. Damn. So they will take a disorder, but they will still get to move their 12 inches, which is okay.
Where would you like them?
Basically, I want you to snake them through here.
So up to there?
Yeah, up to there is good. Because that'll still keep me far enough away from the rest of your army that's about to roll in on me. And it might force you to go, oh crap, here.
It might do. Token?
Yes, to show they're activated. The commander is going to move through the lines with them.
Do you not want to activate these?
Yes, I do want to activate those. They are going to... they'll need to test, but they're going to go for a combined.
Okay. You declare what the combined is before you test.
They're going to column.
Yeah.
Sorry, line. Is it line or column?
Column. They form in column.
Right. Column and move.
Yeah. Just in case you might not want to do that.
Yeah.
Skirmishers can reform in any direction.
Oh.
Which includes mounting up.
I'll tell you what.
Which would mean that I would potentially get a charge, because they'd remount combined action charge.
Oof. See, I thought I was being clever.
You are. I don't know when they're going to come out, and you could have done other things in the meantime.
Uh-huh.
But I don't want...
Yeah, you don't want me just to, because of a tactical flaw for me.
Yeah.
So basically, whenever they reform, they can reform this way.
Well, no, they'd only be able to reform facing that way or this way.
Uh-huh.
So they can't reform facing, like, as a line here.
Yeah.
But because they can reform facing that way as cavalry, they'd be facing in this direction. They've got 8 inches plus 2d3 for their charge. That corner will hit.
Yeah.
This corner will try and lap round.
And that's me in the back end.
Yeah.
Tell you what, the cavalry that's left there, how far would they have to get?
What, to charge me?
I don't think I can do it from there at all.
You go...
So it's four for the river.
Four for the river, which is your 8 inches.
Yeah.
And so you need to get three, four, five. You need to get five.
Five on the
2d3. Which is a three and a two.
Which is doable.
It is doable. You know my fire won't be that great. Because you're going through the river, you won't get a save against it.
That's fine. I'm going to go for it.
Also, what you could do is because of this, I'd have to decide whether I wanted to hold my fire.
Yeah.
And if I hold my fire, I use the inspiration token that I'd use to reform that
I'll
charge.
I'll do that.
So I'm assuming you're going into my heavies.
Yeah.
So they're not going to hold their fire because I'm hoping you won't roll high enough.
Okay. In the tray.
Oh, yeah. I got too excited. So, fives on the blacks, six on the whites. One hit.
I'll throw the officer in.
Yeah.
To make it... this is my regular one, so it's force.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
So, one damage?
One damage. That's unfortunate, but it happens.
And so, now, charge.
Yeah, so now for the charge. Come on. Oh, no good.
Right.
So that is...
Four,
yeah.
So you get... gets you to the river.
Yeah.
Then you go four through the river, so you're just...
An inch short.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
If that hit me, you'd have destroyed two of my heavy cavalry stands without me getting to roll. Then you would have rolled your attack.
Yeah, but it now means that's right beside you. And if you turn to get after me, I'm going to go right into your rear as well.
This will be really interesting.
Yeah.
Because where do you want him to go?
Oh, him? Let's pop him just between the units so they can both activate next round.
Yeah, you don't want him within two of any of them.
Yeah, just outside of two, if you please.
Brigadier 3, you can take an inspiration.
He will. Oh, I could have held my water and had an inspiration for that charge.
Brigadier 3!
Oh, yeah. You're Brigadier 3.
He's going to do what you should have done.
Right. Inspiration. Hi. Well, now you know I've gone.
Yes, that's
the problem.
Why
and I
it.
Thought if I was doing this.
It's what caused me the same thing here.
Yes.
I was like, my card came up first. Do I activate
just
now?
Go or no?
Brigadier 1. It's this dude here.
Yeah, who's now a level 2.
Same problem as Justin just had.
Yeah. I mean, you could rally up your grenadiers.
No, he needs to take inspiration, I think.
Okay. This is where it could all go pear-shaped.
Brigadier 2, it's these guys.
Yep, so...
That's not so bad for me.
Again,
do you want to know how far away you are?
Yes. Can I get within range?
You can if you roll a 2 or more with the front unit.
Right, so I will automatically pass it and try for the big move.
Yep.
So, rolling for a 2 or more. Ah, Only the one.
So you're just out, you have 5 inches.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'll double check that because to make sure I hadn't made a mistake.
What about the other unit on the... I know, it would all be the same, wouldn't it?
What? Which unit?
Oh, the calf.
They're just out as well.
Ah.
No, you got one stand maybe in... We'll call it in.
Okay, I'll take that shot.
It's minus one to these, so it's sixes. So
no good.
That'd have been really good otherwise. Skirmishes. So
yeah, the other guys are just gonna move up the normal. Yeah, I think that's the wisest. Just give a bit of breathing room for stuff.
Yeah,
because eventually I'm kind of traffic jammed here.
Yeah. And the rest of them?
Yep, same again. And commander within two of the front ranks.
Yeah.
I'm hoping I can just give you enough so that it's you have got to deal with it.
There is a lot of men coming in there.
Yeah.
All 2,100 of them. they've activated.
So yes. So token. That's fine. Next. Brigadier 2.
Inspiration?
Yeah, he'll take the inspiration back.
I've got one.
That's fine.
You've been so far over my end, I've got your tokens. My Brigadier 2.
Oh, so now you get to bring in your new squads. Or new regiments.
Yeah. Not within 12. So that I can't do.
Yeah, it's one of the things I was trying to do with getting the extra... If I got the extra movement on them, I could have really got them into a safe position. What do we got?
Well, I'm debating whether to come on this flank or that flank over there. If I come on that flank, I get embroiled in this, but there are more troops there, and I might be able to hold that side. Mm. So I come on over here.
Okay.
So these regulars.
Uh-huh.
Can you imagine all their little fifes and drums and...
Yeah. See, I anytime I imagine this, I always just have the Waterloo music stuck in my head. So I know it's British. Calm down.
I'm British.
that's looking horrible. Because what I can see happening is one unit turning to face my cavalry, the next one moving up and turning to face the other waves coming in.
Yeah.
So I am now on the clock.
Yes. There was nothing better than getting my reserves when I did.
Yeah.
Including my Highlanders.
Oh, Highlanders?
Yeah.
Are they... Oh, God, I'm seeing spears down.
Yeah.
Bayonets to the front.
So Highlanders are regulars with plus one courage.
Uh-huh.
So they're courage 4 plus, same as the Grenadiers.
Oh,
and they
that's
are,
a big unit.
They get charge plus one. So even if you charge them, they're hitting the same as regulars.
Yeah.
But if they get charge plus one and they charge you, they're hitting on fours.
Oh. So. Okay. And their commander?
Yeah.
Where's he going to stand?
In front of them, obviously.
Lead the way.
What was his name? Oh, there's a British officer at Waterloo who went wearing something beginning with P. Anyway.
P. Okay.
I want to say Pickett, but I don't think that's right. he was leading his brigade in front with in a top hat and tails. I think he had an umbrella as well. Riding over, he gets shot because he's British.
I wonder why.
But yeah, crazy British officers.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh,
nice.
That
yeah,
is.
I see.
Ooh.
Now you've put me into your problem. So what I think's going to happen is I'm going to activate a couple of things.
Yeah.
So just because I know I can hurt them, Grenadiers going to take full shots from here.
Yep.
And then, yeah, I'll just do that first, and then we'll figure everything out. So I'm not just calling everything before I do everything. So Grenadiers activating and shisting. So fours and fives, I think it is, yeah?
Yep.
So blacks
fours on and fours.
Oh, fours and fours?
Yeah, because you're within 4 inches.
Okay, fours and fours. So hopefully I can do a bit more damage to that unit. Yep. I will take that
three.
For three.
I will throw in the... Brigadier 1.
Mm-hmm.
Takes him down to threes.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I'll throw in the Brigadier 1.
Takes
and
one.
One, which is exactly what I needed to do.
Yeah. That's fine. Okay. Next up, there's a cannon. Cannon may as well just fire canister into that, or just fire into that flank and get the full rate of fire again.
Sixes.
Yeah. So it's going to fire from where it is here.
Yeah.
Into the flank here, because it's the best shot I have with it. Mm-hmm. Sixes, come on. Oh, one run out. Yep. Nothing. Nothing.
And then again.
Yes, because it didn't move. Yep. Yep, there's one.
I will throw in the officer because it makes no difference anyway.
Yep.
To make it five still, minus one, plus one.
Uh-huh. Six. Didn't even need him.
No.
All right. Because your units are getting battered, I think it is time just to activate everything and just keep hammering you. So from where we are here, this unit will activate and they will just shoot everything at them.
Yep.
Because you could shoot me on the way in this time.
And I've left... The reason I didn't spend the inspiration token is to allow me to fire while closing fire.
Yep. So it's 10 dice. Fives and fours?
Fives and fours.
So fours on the whites.
Ooh,
that's... three.
Three. That's my CIC, isn't it?
Yeah, it is your CIC.
So I will... take them as they are. Ooh, I'm glad I didn't throw them in.
Yeah, yeah. So that's a stand and a point.
Yeah.
All right.
That brigade's hurting.
Yep, and I'm going to rotate here and shoot.
Yeah.
So they're going to just like that.
Mm-hmm.
And now, do I want to break down your big unit or do I really want to just murder that smaller unit? Because then I can start getting into the flank of the other guys.
Not your whole unit will be an arc at the moment.
Mm, true.
Like they'll almost all be in the flank arc, those that can fire, but...
Well, I had a little more movement, so... I think that brings... four stands in. I'll tell you what, I'll just fire everything into the front of the other. But that is 14.
Like, if you... Don't forget, if you kill that unit, I'll have to test for everything in that brigade. Apart from the support gun.
Oh, well, they've only got three left, and I would have one, two, three, call it four in the flank.
Mm-hmm.
So that would be eight dice. Yeah, you know what? Hell with it. Let's go.
How many is within 4 inches?
That is important. So there's four. So out, out, in, in.
So roll two that are in separately, because they've got fives and fours.
Yeah, so fives and fours. Blacks on fours, so two hits.
Two hits.
And then the others on fives and fives, not a bean.
So they are in my flank. I'm not going to throw in my officer. Yes, I... No, I'm not. But everything's activated over there.
Yeah.
Everything's activated over there, so I'll throw in the inspiration.
Okay.
So fives again.
Uh-huh. Oh,
I'm so glad I did that. Right. Everything on your army's gone.
Yes, the rest for me is just inspiration.
My CIC.
Uh-huh. So you can just gather up to your last activation.
So he hasn't gone yet?
Nope.
Only Brigadier 2's gone. So yes. He's going to rally that unit there.
Ah, I thought you might. For one.
Oh.
But it is a standby. Oh no, it's just a wound off.
Yeah.
Oof, that's rough.
Ooh. Brigadier 2, he's already gone, so he's going to
just grab an himself. Inspiration. And it's my CIC who's going to grab inspiration. See, this is what I'm hoping is everything else of mine is inspiration now, so I'm hoping
Brigadier 1, he has already activated.
He did, yes. So he could be rallying this unit because they're in a bad state.
Well, I got one more CIC.
Mm-hmm. So this is what I'm hoping is that I've done enough damage that you just have to reform yourself for a while.
No, I can wait for these to arrive. These guys are going to activate.
Okay. What are they doing?
They are... moving...
two.
Like that.
Okay.
So you don't have a flank shot.
Mm-hmm.
Apart from with maybe your grenadiers.
Yeah.
They're going to pump...
everything.
They're shooting. That'll still be on your front, though, so they might as well pump it into the bigger unit.
Okay.
Try and cause enough damage that...
Yeah, when I'm having to recoil a little bit.
When these guys get there, there's nothing to stop them.
Aye.
So fives and fours. Fours on the black, because I'm not within 4 inches.
Yep.
Three hits.
Okay. So it's fives normally.
Yeah.
Turn it into fours with the inspiration.
Yeah.
Yep. Ugh.
Stand.
Yeah, it is. Thankfully, my officer wasn't in it.
These guys are going to also drop back a bit, so their flank isn't exposed.
Yeah.
Pump into you. I think they're within 4 inches.
They are. Of this unit?
Yeah.
Yep.
So, fours and fours.
Uh-huh.
Ooh. Three.
Okay. On fives. Yep.
That's another stand.
Ugh. Take that.
Gun.
Uh-huh.
If I get it to there. No, there's no way I can get canister into you.
I'm too close.
Because I'll be in the way.
Yeah.
And there's no way I can get across your lines, so I'm going to pump.
But you've got canister into these all there.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to do.
Yeah.
So your grenadiers, five and sixes.
Okay.
The wrong way around, one hit.
One hit, okay. On a four becomes a five.
Mm-hmm.
I'll throw the officer in.
Yeah.
For a four. Nope. So they will take a point. That's okay.
I'll turn my grenadiers and move them back slightly.
Uh-huh.
And then pump them into you as well. Are they still within 4 inches? Because I've wiggled back.
I'll tell you now. There's four there. One yes, the other no.
Right, so we'll roll one separately. So threes and fours, threes on the black. One.
One.
Threes and fives.
Uh-huh.
One. Two hits.
So two hits. I'll throw the officer in to make it threes.
Yeah.
One point. That's fine. They can stand and take that on the chin. That was then, into here, yeah, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Then these guys.
Uh-huh. Oh, you're going up the other side of the table.
Yeah.
Moving within eight.
Yep.
Okay.
So 10 dice.
Yep. This might sting.
Still at quite long range. Well, it's at long range. So fives on the whites, fours on the blacks.
Go for it.
I can't roll. Two hits.
Okay. Throw the commander in.
Yep.
Actually, I don't need to. I'll just burn his inspiration to turn it into threes. Yeah. Turn it into threes. Yep. Ah, oh, take one.
One through.
That's okay.
I don't have any of your damage over this side, unfortunately.
That's fine. That's the first damage I've seen on this side, really.
It is.
All right, and flip.
So, Brigadier 1. So you can rally.
Yes, I will begin to rally. So I will rally this unit.
Mm-hmm. So twos or threes returns a stand.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yes.
Twos, that's one stand back.
Okay, that's... Fantabulous.
Brigadier 3, right. So, remounting and charging.
Yeah. So you're spending your inspiration for it, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can see me and you've definitely got me.
Yeah.
Because I think definitely within it there.
Well, it's 8 for that one and 2d3.
Yeah.
So, where did I just put the others?
Oh yeah, that's my cannon that's dead.
Extra two, so they go 10.
Yeah, you're well in.
Yeah, that's the whole lot. I believe the best I can do is three stands on you, unfortunately.
Okay.
Right, so...
Do I get to fight?
You do. No, you're being hit in the rear.
Mm.
So, they're skill 5.
Mm-hmm.
They've got charge plus 2.
Uh-huh.
Takes them down to 3. They're hitting you in the rear. They get plus 1 and you can't fight.
Okay.
So, 2's in the rear.
Oof.
3 dice, not 4. I was about to cheat.
Ones. Three dead. So that stings.
Yeah.
So 1, 2, 3.
You then recoil because your cavalry 2d3.
Okay. 2d3. That's
4.
4. Okay.
And then I'm heavy. Cav.
4. You might just so catch me and run me down.
I can declare a charge again.
Yeah.
So I will.
So you're in. Hit me again.
So, 3 dice again.
Yeah. finish it.
Yep. Ooh, only just. But, finish them.
But what's the range on the test?
Anything is in your brigade, so they have to test.
Yep, okay, so just on the courage.
Yep.
Of a five.
And they lose a stand if they fail.
Mm-hmm. Oof, they lose one. So one stand off.
Which
The one next to me.
Next to you?
Yeah.
This one?
Yeah.
I got a second inspiration. Mount up and charge.
Well, you are charging into that river.
Luckily, you're not mounted. You're mounted, sorry.
Yeah,
I keep knocking my unit.
All closed in, yeah. Come and get me. And is that lights versus lights then?
That's lights versus lights.
Okay.
So
it really was who got it first this time.
Yeah.
Oh, no, sorry. It was my tactical mistake to move and feel. Ugh. So you've got all four of yours.
Yeah, that damage did go from you.
Yeah.
You've still got that inspiration. I got four of mine. They're light, so they only hit on fours.
Mm-hmm.
They're skill five. Mm-hmm. They got plus one because they got charged plus one.
Yep. Hit me.
So fours.
Oh, that'll
three,
be it.
That's the whole three. Lot. This is not gone. Good. So that's gone.
I have to test for my forces now.
He's dead.
Yeah. I have to test for my entire force now, don't
Every single battalion has to test.
All right, so...
Apart from me, guns.
So I'll just roll it next and I'm for hand this. So this one?
You can throw him in for plus one.
But then he risks going away.
Yeah.
No, just... they'll just lose a stand, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, so this one for a five. No.
Which
this one for a five. This end. This one for a five. No. This one for a five. No. These guys for a four? No.
And you lose the damage, though.
Okay. These guys for a five, they're fine. These guys for a five, they're fine. And the cannon?
Doesn't test.
Okay. That's fine.
It's good, because you failed it. The cannon's a support unit, so it never tests.
Yeah, okay.
But if everything in its brigade dies, it dies.
Although this is dead bad for me.
Yes.
Because now... Your cavalry has thumped through at the top here, so I'm going to have to bring these guys forward and try and swing around.
Yeah.
To get fire on your cavalry.
That's a bit of a change of of the battle.
Yeah. The good thing for me is your heavies are down here kind of neutered at the minute.
Yes.
Right. What round are we on?
We are on... I think we're on round five.
Five? Okay. I think, what had we said beforehand? Six or seven we were going to end on?
Yeah.
Let's go with six and we'll roll for seven, yeah?
Yep.
Okay. Flip.
Oh, yeah, I forgot there's still a turn left.
Brigadier one.
So you can rally back those guys that just disappeared from your grenadiers.
This is his first or second?
Second activation. Second activation.
It will be on a three, so it's a five plus to get them back. I think I'd rather be rallying back for this unit.
Yep.
Which is on a 3+. And I get it. And I got the... Oh, I got the 5. But it does mean this unit is full strength again.
Yes. Last two. Uh-huh. So your CIC.
Yep, he's going to do a rally on my other big-ish unit here.
Mm-hmm.
So looking for a 3. He gets it. So I get a stand back.
My CIC is going to rally on the smaller unit.
I thought you might.
Still fail it.
Nothing. Right. Set for round six.
Yeah.
Okay, let's go.
Right. This is the important card.
Mm-hmm. Brigadier 2.
That's not what I wanted to see.
That's actually really helpful for me. So, what I can do then... Is so this unit's going to activate, move forward 4 and shoot at short range.
Yep.
And that's 6.
Yep.
It's 12 dice. I need one more black dice. You've been hogging all the dice over here.
I know. Surprising considering my units are smaller.
There we go. Even split again. So it's 12 dice, 5s and 4s.
Fours.
So 4s on the white dice.
Yep.
Come on. Ooh, I'll take that. So five.
So five hits?
Five hits, yeah. I wish it called the fours on the black.
Don't worry, five hits is probably enough. I don't have an officer to support me. I don't have inspiration, so it's just fives. Three? Ooh,
three go. Well, yeah, so a stand and...
Point of damage?
Point of damage, yeah. That's fine. So the next thing that's going to happen is this unit's going to wheel, but they're going to try to get the extra movement on that wheel. So for a five, nope. So they'll take a point, but they will wheel for four and shoot.
What are they shooting?
Well, if they're in range, maybe that cavalry of yours.
No.
Am I?
You needed the D3.
Yeah. But I've at least got something facing you now. The other unit can't really do anything, so I think they're going to try for a bit of a shimmy of 2 inches. So they're going to shimmy so that they're wheeling back by two. About there?
Yep.
Just to try and reform the line slightly. I think it's all I've really got right now. Draw. Brigadier 2 for you. So that's all of your gear at the back there.
They're going to get an inspiration.
Uh-huh. Brigadier 2 again. So now you get to shift them all.
Yeah. Well, they're just going to move 4 inches.
Uh-huh. Yeah, so they're all pretty much at the front of that field now.
Yeah. I'll move him to the front as well.
Yeah, just for handiness.
They're marching like a Russell Crowe in Gladiator. Arms out.
Oh yeah, one thing I forgot to do. This commander.
Oh yeah.
I want to keep him within two of these. And these.
Okay.
Now, I assume your units can't split fire.
No.
Okay. See, if only I got here a little sooner, I could have wiped these out and just been catching you in the flank.
Mm-hmm.
Would have been nice, but oh well. Okay?
Yep.
Draw.
Brigadier 1.
Ooh, this is good. This is very good. So, we're going to begin with some orderings. Maintenant, it will move. To here. And look at a star in the side. For sixes.
Yep.
And that. Because if I get something, it's in the side. And I do.
You do. So fives, I'm going to. It goes up to six. Artillery goes up to nothing.
Yeah.
Flank. Put the officer in for sixes.
Oh, whoa! He gets it. Oh, damn it. All right, this unit, which is now six stands, is going to shoot
into the two.
Into the two. Into the two, because they must die. And I should stop doing horrible French accents, because French people will hit me. fives and fours. Fours on the black.
Yeah.
Oh, ooh. Good shot. That six. Should wipe them. Yeah, six, seven actually.
Seven?
Seven. Oh, yeah.
I'm not going to stick in the officer, there's no point.
I think it was seven. Go for six.
Okay.
Yeah, just...
Roll dice. Four plus, this is seven.
Okay.
Yeah, seven.
I wasn't sure. I wasn't sure I miscounted. But good to have an opponent that'll do that.
Yeah, we'll find out in the comments. I'm sure.
Justin, you cheated! Why?
Only if I save everything. But three.
Or if you
four.
Feel by one.
Yeah.
Go for it. Fives?
Fives. Oh, look, I failed by one. No, I didn't.
Yeah, actually, you did fail by one.
No, I failed by two.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
If I'd thrown the officer in, I'd have failed by one.
Yeah, but that's okay, because now you're testing.
So these guys?
Yeah.
I'm going to throw them in.
Yeah, clear that. For four?
Oh,
nope.
No. Do you want to roll for him?
Oh, yeah, roll for him. For a six?
Yeah.
Nope. What's your next unit?
Grenadiers.
Grenadiers, yeah.
I'm going to throw in Brigadier 1.
For 3.
For 3.
Oh, nope. So on a 6. Oh, out of the tray. Yep. Yes. One goes. That's fabulous news for me. Actually, you've also got to do 4 then.
Oh, yeah.
And they feel too. This is excellent news for me.
Ooh.
That was tasty.
I think I just failed every roll.
It's about to get worse. These guys into the three for 14 dice.
I think if you can do this, you might be close to...
Yeah, to breaking your army.
Oh, unless it ends this turn.
Oh. We'll see. So that's 14.
Yeah.
Four's on the black dice, I think.
Yeah.
Well, actually, Heron, I think I need to move a little. Yep, just a little.
You don't have to.
No, I'll move. So we're there. 14 dice. Four's on the black dice. Oh, come on, baby. Stop. Ooh, yes.
It's a lot of hits.
I've
got to throw in that officer, I think.
So that's,
I don't know if I throw him in.
That's eight.
I've lost Brigadier 1 already.
Yeah, that'll be your CIC.
And that'll be my CIC, who's the only person that can order those troops. Yeah,
but it's 8 on 5s, which could vaporise them.
Yeah, but if he dies...
Yeah.
Because he's only going to reduce it down to 4s.
If they die, it's a risky one. I've caught you flat-footed without the inspiration to actually save yourself a bit here.
I don't know if he's within 2 inches, Justin. This might actually make it a moot point.
He is. He's on the line. You can have it if you want it.
That takes me back to the original problem I had. I thought it was going to solve it for me. No, I will.
8 on 5s.
8 on 5s. Oh, they're dead.
Vaporized.
I'm so glad I didn't throw him in.
Yeah, because that would have been, what, 3 tests for him?
Yeah.
So those 3 go. And now you're testing for... Here.
Here.
And for here. So they fail.
Fail. So the grenadiers are gone.
Yeah.
So they need to do 2 tests.
Yeah. Pass one, fail one. That's fine by me. Right. That makes it important what I'm doing now.
What are your grenadiers going to do, Justin?
So these. Your cannons in the town is my problem.
Yeah.
Can I occupy the town with you at the same time?
So we said at the start you couldn't, but the cannon is a support unit.
Yeah.
So it doesn't count for breaks or anything like that. So I would argue if the cannon's in there by itself, yes.
Okay.
Because the rules are still in development, I'm not sure. But I think if they're a support unit, if you killed it, I don't get any modifiers. And it's never testing.
Yeah.
Because by now it should have tested 3 times.
Yeah.
Which it would be dead, because it's only got courage 5.
Yeah, and there's none of its regiment nearby. So I would say it's a small force. You could move in.
Yeah, well, that's 200 men versus 3 artillery pieces.
Yeah. All right, so what I'll do with these guys is they're going to try for a super quick shuffle across the river. So they're going to have to test.
Yeah.
So that's on a 4.
They get a reroll because they're well-drilled.
Yeah, so for a 4, they get it. So it's D3 across the river. On top, so it's an additional 1, so that becomes a 1/2 inch.
Yep.
So from where they are, it's 1 inch.
You got 3 inches, because it's 1 inch to the thing.
Yep. So it's 1 inch, cut in 1/2, 3 inches total.
Yep.
So they're in the river, and they will shoot. This guy's got a bit here.
Yeah, because the gun.
So that'll be 4 dice.
-2, which takes... you to above 6s on your equipment. Unless you're within 4 inches.
I am within 4 inches.
So luckily for you, you haven't given the +1 to the armour.
Yeah.
So they only get the +1 for the town.
So it's...
6s on your equipment.
Yeah.
And -2, 6s on... 6s and 6s.
6s and 6s? I'll take it. Yep.
Of course 2. You will. So he gets courage 4+, because he's in the town.
Oh, feels dead. Both, and it's gone. And is that... No, it doesn't cause tests.
Nope.
But that's good. Well, it would have been good if I'd made it into the town, because I need the next turn so that I can actually get into the town for the win.
Yeah.
Draw. All of my stuff is activated, so it's really down to what you do with yours. My
Your CIC, inspiration.
Inspiration, of course. So
my Brigadier 1, he's dead.
Brigadier 2 for me. He's grabbing inspiration just to try and keep them all alive up there.
CIC,
he's here for you.
So
he could... Oh, they've activated.
They haven't?
Oh, yeah,
they charged you down.
Yeah, so you could activate them.
It's got to go here.
Yeah, to try and bring back some coherency.
Well, also, if you notice, I was an idiot.
Oh, right.
They're out of command of their brigadier. So if he didn't come back, they'd have just sat there like lemmings.
Good shot. Oh, so he's moving back and grabbing an inspiration.
Yes, you can move. So they can always move, but they only do whatever their action is at the beginning or the end.
Gotcha. Next. Brigadier 1, who's dead. Brigadier 1 for me, who's just going to grab inspiration.
Brigadier 3 is here. So they can go 4 inches across here.
Yeah. Oh, no. There. He's coming for me.
But they don't need to do that yet.
You have so much speed there, now you can just hook around my rear.
I don't think it'll make any difference.
Well, if I can get in there.
That's what I mean. If you can get... Well, if the game continues.
Yeah. If we get another turn.
if you don't get another turn.
Yeah.
Oh, right. I need to keep drawing. Uh-huh. Your CIC.
My CIC, of course, is just going to grab inspiration, because if there's another turn...
Your CIC.
Another inspiration.
My Brigadier 3.
So, for next turn, I'm pretty good for inspiration. It's just, is it going to be there?
He's going to spend that inspiration.
Uh-huh. Guarantee them the 2d3 extra.
Well, the 4 inches gets them across there, so the 2d3 extra gets them past it.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Oh, so 6.
So 4 to there to get them across.
Speedy, and then 6.
And then 6. I need to be careful now.
Yeah, with how you turn so I don't flank you.
Yep. I can combine a charge and on the double to make them go 8 plus 3d3.
Ooh.
I thought I'd tell you because these guys...
Might get it in the back end, yeah.
I would risk being shot myself in the rear to destroy one of your units.
Well, my thing is, these guys are going to block out and shoot and hopefully block you from being able to do that because you would have to hit the first unit you come in contact with.
Oh, if you were right in the way, I couldn't... I'd have to do that kind of weird charge. I'd have to then come out here,
wiggle,
and then come in.
Yeah, yeah. And the last one is your CIC. What's he going to do? Is he going to bring your cavalry back, or are they coming up?
Well, they can't fire.
Oh crap! You going to charge?
Yes, I am.
All right.
You're 12 inches away.
Yeah.
I'm going to use my inspiration.
Yeah.
To provide the bonus.
A plus one.
No.
What?
Of an extra D3. The thing I just talked about.
Oh, right.
8 plus 3D3.
Okay.
So I need a 12.
11. I need to roll 1 and 2.
Oh my God.
You've got it and then some. How about you fill your boots, son?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. The cavalry. The cavalry! But the good news for me is... Oh, I can plus 3 my attacks back at you when I eventually get them.
Yeah, if you get them. I can only kill 4 stands.
4 stands, so I would get 2 dice back.
Yeah.
So I can take half of them.
That's if I get them all. At the moment, I'm going to get 5s, 3s.
Yeah.
So 3 dead.
Uh-huh. And I get to fight back.
With 3.
Yes, and I'm going to throw the pluses in, like buggery. So it's 3 pluses.
So 3s on 3 on 3s. 5, 4, 3, 2.
2s. 3 on 2s.
Yeah.
This could be quite bloody for you.
You can't do that yet. You might be dead.
Why?
Because you were within 2 inches of that unit and they just lost 3 stands.
Ah, yes. So.
So 3d6.
Yeah. For any 6s. Yeah. Oh, God, he's gone.
Ow. I was excited. So that went from, oh my God, this is amazing, to, I feel bad for Justin.
I feel really bad that the commander dies in a cavalry charge.
Well, he was going, come on, men, we'll fight them. You even
he was all freaking gung ho for it.
You've still got the inspiration here.
I do, so I'll make it 4s.
Yeah.
Yep. That's 2 of yours, but I lose.
And you get pushed back.
Yeah. So let me get my stuff out the way. D3 back for 2 inches.
And then I'm gonna hit you again.
Well, actually, because of where stuff's dead. Oh yeah, you can still move and get me. Yeah, so you're going to come in and hit me again. On 3s.
2 more dead.
I get to fight back with 1. Use that. So it's 1 on 5. No. So I get pushed back again. So I'm still alive.
Yeah, I was...
But this is horrendous.
I was hoping for a little bit more. I feel a little bit bad saying that. I was hoping for a bit more. Killed your CIC. Destroyed a unit. They're going to move 12 inches to here.
Especially when the CIC was going to make such a huge difference to that combat. If I had those dice on twos...
I wouldn't have a heavy cavalry unit.
Well, you would, but it would be repulsed. Because you would have lost the combat.
Yeah.
Which doesn't really happen to heavy cavalry that often.
No.
So very, very much a shame.
Well, that's the problem with charging. So if you charge formed infantry in the front, especially if they've got loaded muskets.
Yeah, it's bad.
It's very bad.
But if you have a CIC nearby who's fully loaded and not within two, that's even worse.
Yes. Like, luckily for me, you needed him for the saves against the shooting.
Yeah.
That's the end of the turn. So you lost your CIC.
Yeah. Rolling to see if we get the next turn. What do we want that on?
3+?
Let's go 4, 50-50.
Yeah, okay.
Ah, damn it!
I've just...
You won.
Won.
This is actually interesting, because the way the battle's left here, I could have got these in here, held to the end of the turn.
Well, these can't get there. Like, if they activate to get there, they're going to have to stay in column.
Yeah.
Which means that I have to fight. I won't be able to fight you, because I'm in column. And all the rest of yours are in line.
Yeah.
I think it's also down to whether my heavy cavalry... My heavy cavalry get to activate.
Mm-hmm. But could they swing in time? Like, you
I'd destroy that unit and hope that it causes a ripple effect.
So what you would do is you'd destroy this unit.
And then hope that this fails twice.
Yeah.
Because that's the unit that's going to be in the town.
Yeah, and you could probably get a decent charge on this and possibly wreck it to start sending ripples through as well. It will be a close one.
So tight.
Oh, I like how the game system's working. Yeah. I like not being able to shoot whenever you've activated it.
Yes.
Because I know you say in this game you don't need to reload, but your NCOs should be taking care of that. But whenever you've activated it for the turn, your attention is elsewhere. You're maybe you fired, maybe that's the point where you're reloading.
Well, it would have changed the game completely. I wouldn't have charged you at all with my cavalry, because you'd have hurt me coming in.
Yeah, yeah.
Here, when you charged my infantry, you wouldn't have done it, because I had almost a full strength unit.
Yeah.
We'd have just been stuck in a nasty firefight moment.
Yeah. All right, well, everybody, I tell you what, get your comments in below. Tell us what you think of World War Zero. I have really enjoyed that. We'll move on. We'll see you again soon.
We hope you enjoyed this Let's Play. Go ahead and check out our other content on screen now, and be sure to check out beastsofwar.com for the latest gaming news and gaming Let's Plays. And while you're at it, why not hit subscribe, and remember to ding our dong. Go on, you know you want to click it. Go on.